Are you ready?
We're gonna take a little break, so don't go away for goodness sake. We're gonna have a little smoke and powder our nose, and then we'll be back to tickle your toes.
Welcome to the Night Gallery. Tonight's episode is Where Do Dead Guitars Go? When attempting a mass rescue issue, it's best to attend to the people or patients that might live. This is how we will proceed. Welcome to Dave's Night Gallery. Okay, before I get into this sequence of events, I don't want to disrespect anybody. I know that the owner of this stuff brought it to me in good faith, and maybe I mistook what his expectations were, or maybe, I don't know, maybe. Anyhow, this is not Dave's pet cemetery. I'm making a joke, right? You can't just bring it here when it's dead and think it's going to come back to life, you know, like the movie. This ain't pet cemetery. But this one looked the most hopeful. Let's plug it in and see if it even makes a sound. That would be the first miraculous adventure of this multi-part series of Dave's Night Gallery. Because I want you folks to be here with me for all the thrills, chills, and horror that is about to come your way. Okay. Okay, now that I know that's going to happen, let's just give these a few spins before we turn the amp back on. I'm sorry. I was having fun pretending to be scared, and that really scared me. I was not prepared for that whatsoever. Okay, let's see what happens now. Because usually just because they've been sitting for like 100 years, that's why they don't work very well. But I believe everything is zeroed. Maybe a little more cleaning. It definitely is some single coil. Yeah, it's making a sound, but the strings are like that far off the pickup, so. But it is what it is. It makes noise. Okay, next, in the funhouse. In the funhouse, next, in the funhouse. Sure is a hummy little thing, isn't it? Kind of like a soundtrack to one of those scary old crappy movies. The other thing I forgot to mention is this thing is, well, I think it's the cleanest of the bunch. But right now, I didn't even tune it up to pitch, but I'm just looking at the neck. And it's like, oh, it's pretty bad. Like, you know. So let's get that end off, and I don't know, I gotta put gloves on, I think. Right. No, so I gotta start a new rule, right? Okay, my new rule is leave your dust at home. Please, leave your dust at home. Maybe I should be wearing my mask touching this. I don't know. What's in there? Looks like a big crappy 5 mil. Seeing as this thing's made where I didn't look. What's it even called? A gem tone. My gems are already toning. Made in Japan. Are they lying? Oh, and of course this is too deep. Yeah, it's a 5. I got a shorty 5. Hang on. I got a shorty 5. Shorty 5 coming up. That didn't take long. Well, it sort of turns in the right way. Whether we can straighten it out at all remains to be seen. Let's just loosen off these crappy old strings a bit. Maybe give it some help. But, you know, I mean, it's not even worth a new set of strings if we can't. See why I put gloves on? It's like, don't do this to me, folks, please. It's not nice, especially with the current situation. Well, it's sort of getting to turn quite a bit. Stay tuned for more cartoons. Well, that's a good sign. I got a good few cranks on it. Let's tune it up and see what happened.
Well, talk about scary stuff. Which is that guy. We don't like that kind. Too much noisy, so something's wrong there. Back to the house of frightening things. Stand by, I really haven't even turned it up. I was trying to get over the 60 cycle hum. This is right about when the real frightening jigsaw frickin' guy comes to life, because I'm gonna tune up these little strings and one's gonna snap right in my face. I just want to see if I make the next straight. Snap! Snap! Close enough. I'm just gonna look at it. That didn't do anything. Nope, it's a toaster. I'll show you in a minute. It's a goner, well, needs a lot of work. Well, there's your problem, boss. Your surfboard's done come away from the waves. Oh my goodness. Oh yeah, I could just probably pull that all off with my fingers. So, I mean, okay. Let's be fair. If this was my guitar and I had nothing to do, because my hourly rate is very, very cheap if I'm working for me, I'd throw it in a corner, and when I really felt ambitious, I'd maybe give it a look. But right now, we're not even sure if the truss rod works because the fingerboard's separated from the neck. We got a buzzy electronical thing going on. What can I tell you? It's a restoration project that, for me, I can do it, but I really can't put a dollar figure on it because it's going to take time. And it's not for me, it's for you, so. Number one, episode one of Dave's Night Gallery Guitars. I'm going to put this in a body bag and wish everyone a good night. Be safe, be good to each other. Cheers. Bye now.